So this is part 2 of using Vard Linux. So in this part we will be dealing with managing services. So Vard Linux is having an init system called Runit. So in Runit you manage services by symbolic links. So if you do a sudo ls -l /hc runit and run svdir, you can see the symbolic links available. So you have like two run levels. So one is default and another one is single. So in order for you to run a service, like in order for you to start a service, you have to create a symbolic link between the service directory and var service. So all you have to do is sudo ln -sf /hc. So inside hc you have this directory called sv. So inside sv, if you do a tab, you can see like all the available services like which you can link. So for example, like you can use something like wpa supplicant or dhcp cd, something like that. So for this purpose we can do something like dbus. Dbus is already enabled for me, but I'm just going to show you the way you can enable the service. You are going to create a link to /var and service. So if we create a link like this from sv and the service name to var and service, on the next reboot you'll be having the service enabled by default. So if you want to remove the service from starting up, you can do like sudo rm -f to force, and you can remove from /var and service, and you can remove the service name like for example dbus. So if you do something like this, it will automatically remove the service from var service, so it will not start up in your next boot. So be careful, if you stop dbus you may not have access to your window manager, all the other things. Then the next thing is you can view status of current like one service, like sudo sv. So you can do status followed by the service name, something like dhcp. So dhcp is not available, so I can do something like dbus. So you can see dbus is running and the process identifier number and the number of seconds like from the process I've started. So if you wanna like start a service, you can do up. So if you do like sudo sv up dbus, it will like start the service. If you need to close it, you just like do down, so it will terminate the process like service. And if you need to restart a service, you do a restart and followed by the service name. So that's how you manage your services inside Vard Linux or run it in its system. So another way of doing this is you can, instead of using just the service name, you can do a full path. So you can do something like sudo sv then status. You can use /var and service followed by the service name like dbus. So if you do that, it's still going to give you information. So either way, you are going to get information about the package. If you want to do something like mask in systemctl, like if you want to prevent something from like automatic start, like if you have some firewall that it requires to be disabled by you, and if it restarts even after you disable like this, you can do something like sudo sv, not sv, you can do a touch, and you have to create a file like inside slash etc, touch slash etc, then sv. Inside sv you have the service name. For example, you can don't do dbus, because if you do dbus it will cause issues in your system. And you can specify slash down, so this will mask the service, so it will not do automatic restarts. All your enabled services are inside a directory called run svdir. So if you ls, I may need super user privileges, sudo ls in slash var like a slash etc. Inside etc we have this directory called runit. So inside runit you have this run svdir. So if you do an ls, you can see we have current, default, previous and single. So if you want to see the status of current, you can do slash current. So it will give you all the available services, all the services which are enabled for this user or this session. So if you need to see for single user, you can do single. So it will give you which services available. So that's pretty much it, how you manage services in Ward Linux using Runit as the init system. So I hope this one was helpful. I hope you all have a wonderful day.